So, hey guys, it's Phil here from the Goose Hammock Shop. We're coming into the weekend. It's a scorcher out there right now. We had a crappy couple of days. It's looking good going into this weekend. It is the middle of August. I can't remember the date. I think it's about the 11th. All blends into one for us this time of year. So the fishing, pretty damn good actually right now. So let's start freshwater. The larger fishing's still good. Okay, you need to get over the lily pads and where there's shade and things. The trout are all in the deeper water. I think I said this last week. Try and get into some ponds that not everybody's fishing. Nickerson's a wonderful place to fish. It's got great access. It's a really cool park. There's about 200,000 people fishing it right now. So find somewhere you can't get to easily. But don't go trespassing on somebody's land to get there. There's 380 something ponds, I think, on Cape Cod. You're gonna find one that not that many people are on and have a better chance at it. Okay, pretty much all the lures have been working. Frog hopping's a great way of doing it on the lily pads because the lily pads are out. It's a really kind of fun way of doing it. But try a bit of everything, they'll go for it. And also some people are actually catching smallies now as well, which is really good. So if we come out more to salt water, albies, no, not here yet. The thing we have seen a lot of, certainly in Sakratucket, I was in Sakratucket the other day, you could walk on the peanut bunker. There's billions of the damn things, which means it's staging really well. Striper fishing has been pretty good. Last weekend, for some reason, I don't quite know what happened, but multiple captains reported to me lights out fishing, whether it be in the bay, off Chatham, the rips, everywhere. The fish really wanted to chew. If we look at the bayside first, from the boats, Billingsgate's been doing really well. Getting round off to, obviously, Woodend, getting off Herring Cove and round the backside. There's been some absolute lunker bluefish as well. Lunkers. So make sure you're using a strong fluorocarbon or use wire trace. I personally recommend a strong fluoro because you have more chance of catching stripers. And don't be afraid of fishing under the bluefish. If you find a ton of bluefish on top, we did this on last Wednesday, just last day of tuna season, and we got some lunker blues. We were actually catching them for bait, but if we'd have fished a live mackerel or something under them, there's a fair chance of a good good striped bass underneath. The beaches have been relatively quiet, mainly in the bay because it's really warm. If you can, go there first light, last light into dark. Okay, along the Brewster Flats, actually, people have had some really good results. There's a lot of juvenile sand eel in there, so if you've got sand eel patterns, light jigs, I really like things like the Bill Hurley, the light sand eel jigs that he does. The flies, the little epoxy fly we do is really good if you're using a fly rod, for example. And then the outer beaches are kind of hit and miss. You know, we had a couple of days where it was lights out, and then last night it sucked. So it's kind of up and down, up and down. But you've got to try the beaches. We were fishing along the Norset beaches. Like I say, we were there on Saturday and we got into schoolies. But the you could see the boats during the day were fishing just offshore. They were like probably in 60 foot of water and they were killing it. So those fish move in and they're pushing the bunker up onto the beach. So again, if you can get there after dark, you'll do great. Don't be afraid to keep walking on a beach. What you're going to find is the mung and stuff is patching up in eddies and things and you'll get a whole load of it. Walk 200 yards, you'll probably get out of it. And the northern beaches up off Truro and things have actually done better. So don't be afraid of getting off the Wellfleet beaches and the Truro beaches and even the Race if you can for a chance. Norset, like I say, is up and down at the moment. So the beach fishing really good. We've been using a lot of needlefish because we love them. We're using top water where we can. And we're also using the bucktail jigs have been really successful as well. So those off the beaches have been great. And then if you move to the offshore scene, the tuna fishing, the commercial season closed on Wednesday last week. We were lucky enough, we got a big fish. We had a 107 on Tuesday. We lost a big fish, unfortunately, in the bay on Wednesday, but that's closed down now. The recreational fishing, Winnie, who's one of our retired members of staff who's in touch, he actually doubled up on Sunday, this just gone Sunday, and he had an 84 and a 68. So he tagged and released the 84, Got that swimming away and retained the 68 for the table. And then on his way back, he fished outside the shoals with his mates, and they got their limiter sea bass and their limiter fluke. So that was really cool that that fun fishing was there. The bar bite is he was on bars, and the bar bite is just starting to go off. We had a really good bite east of Chatham up through Norset last year, relatively shallow water. The tuna are further out at the moment. We hope in the coming week or so they'll actually move further to closer to shore, so we'll get a shot at them. South of the islands, they've still been hitting mice. The claw and coxes has done okay. The dump has been okay. The southern end of the dump has been fishing better than northern, and you're getting into the mahi and things and the white marlin. But generally it's good. And the last thing I'm going to say about the boat fishing is the cod fishing. You know, Captain Matt Paraccio on Titan Up was jigging for tuna, couldn't get on a tuna, started getting cod east of Chatham outside the shipping lanes, and togged his boat's limit in half an hour with really good cod. No worms in them as well. So, you know, don't think offshore is just for tuna. You can really get into some fantastic ground fishing if you go out a bit. But also, as Winnie did, he was a mile off the beach and he got his limit of sea bass and fluke. And fluke is probably one of the tastiest sea fish you can get. And sea bass, also probably one of the tastiest. So he ate well for a few days, and I'm waiting for my care package. Anyway, that's about it. The fishing is really good. Just get out there. We're pretty well stocked with everything. Come and see us, get restocked. Remember to use heavy fluoro if you're in anywhere where there's bluefish, or else you're gonna start losing gear. But have a great time out there. Stay safe. Thank you.